الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى يقول في كتاب العطاس استحباب تسمية العاطس عن what to say when someone sneezes and what to say to someone who says الحمد لله. قال وعن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه قال كان اليهود يتعاطسون عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يرجون أن يقول لهم يرحمكم الله، فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لهم يهديكم الله ويصلح بالكم. In this hadith, in the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, that he said, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, he said that the Jews of Medina, they used to intentionally sneeze in the presence of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, hoping that he would say to them, يرحمكم الله, which means may Allah have mercy. But instead he would say, صلى الله عليه وسلم, يهديكم الله ويصلح بالكم, which means may Allah guide you and mend your ways. So he made them two du'a, one for the akhirah and one for the dunya. For the akhirah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you. For the dunya, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make your affairs easy and good for you. So that means even in the dunya, there is nothing wrong making du'a for the people in the dunya, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease their pain, alleviate their suffering, you know, have them, give them a better chance and so forth. And again, for the akhirah, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them. Now, specifically seeking forgiveness for them, it's not in our hand, it's in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He said clearly, Surah An-Nisa, that the mushrikun will never enter of Jannah, that they will never enter of Jannah, they have worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, we have no control over that. And in matters of dunya, even when Ibrahim alayhi salam, he sought forgiveness for his father, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the permission at the beginning, but then that was it. So Ibrahim realized that his father will never, you know, believe, tabarra'a min. He stopped seeking forgiveness for his dad. But eventually he still can make dua for them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, make them, help them out in their suffering and alleviate their suffering and so on. So eventually, if you're in this community and someone sneezes around you, non-Muslim, is it okay to say it bless you? Or to say salud in Spanish? Is it okay to say that? It's okay. You can say that. Now to say alhamdulillah, Allah, just like in hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Nabi instead he said yahdikum Allah. Now even if you say yahdikum Allah, they will say what? So you're going to have to translate that. Say may Allah guide you because of what? Sneezing. So they might not even understand that concept. They might not understand the word, so therefore just respond to them in a way that they understand. At the same time, it still falls under the general guidelines, inshallah ta'ala, of Tashmit al-Aqs. And finally, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu Allah, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا تَثَاءَبَ أَحَدُكُمْ فَلْيُمْسِكْ بِيَدِهِ عَلَى فِيهِ فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَدْخُلْ. رواه مسلم. In this hadith, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when one yawns, he should put his hand over his mouth, try to control. If he could not control that by biting on your lips, then with your hands, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, else the shaitan will enter. Meaning if you don't do that, the shaitan might enter your mouth. Now how does that happen? Allahu ta'ala. This is from ilm al-ghayb. In manners that only Allah knows how. Because again, the shaitan is a creation different than the human beings. They are jinn. So the way they are created is absolutely different than the creation of human beings. So therefore, these things, you know, it's possible. It's possible for that creation. We don't really know. We cannot visualize or comprehend because we don't know the nature of that creation. But the Prophet ﷺ said that. Hadith rawahu Muslim, an authentic hadith, and I believe. Wallahu ta'ala. Now, any question, Imam? Yes. How would that affect you? And there was another hadith, the Prophet says, a shaitan, he laughs at us when we start yawning. Why is that? Because when you yawn and start opening your mouth out loud, you know, and just everybody around you hears that and so forth, that's a sign of what? Laziness? You're getting too lazy? And that's what the shaitan wants, right? He wants to see you all the time, lazy all the time. He doesn't like to see you active, because he knows that when you're active, you do good things, inshallah ta'ala. Hope so. But when you're lazy, that means you're not going to be able to wake up for salah, you don't have the energy to pray, to read the Quran, do whatever it requires to do good deeds. Wallahu a'lam. SubhanAllah, alhamdulillah, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.